Hello and welcome to this week's edition of the Connected Church News for leaders of nonprofits, churches, and faith-based organizations. I'm Natchi Lazarus, and this week we have news from YouTube, Instagram, Sprout Social, and news related to working remotely during this season of coronavirus outbreak around the world, and also news about what social media channels are doing with respect to the coronavirus outbreak. This is the show where we bring you the top 5 digital and social media news you need to know for this week in less than 5 minutes. Let's get started. Our first big news of this week is from Instagram. Instagram seems to be testing a new feature in which it will allow you to save or showcase your Instagram live videos on IGTV immediately after you go live. So if you know in YouTube, you can do that. When you go live on YouTube, after you finish the live stream, you can save that particular video on your YouTube channel. In a similar way, you will be able to very soon do that on IGTV if this testing goes well. So it will be a good feature for people who like to build up your IGTV library, and for the future, even though the video may not be very polished because you're going live, it may not be completely edited and may not look polished, but it is still a good way to store your live streams on your IGTV. So this is being tested by Instagram. Our next news is from YouTube. YouTube announced last week that they are replacing their trending tab with a new tab called Explore. Trending was a tab inside YouTube that allowed you to discover trending videos on YouTube, but now YouTube says this has been expanded and the new tab is called Explore, which will have many more categories apart from the trending videos also. So they're just making the discoverability factor wider inside YouTube, considering that YouTube is the second largest search engine in the world. It's no wonder that they are focusing on making more videos discoverable. And I also think it's because YouTube is starting to think about wider, larger screens like television. More people are watching YouTube on television, so having a Discover tab is almost like it gives you a similar feel to Netflix, you know, where you're browsing around different videos. So I think they're trying to go there. So check it out. Our next news is about social media scheduling. Last week, Sprout Social released a report on the best times to post on various social media channels like Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and LinkedIn. And the report contains some very interesting findings, specifically with respect to different types of content related to media, education, consumer goods. So it's very interesting to see how people consume content related to these items in different timings. So I wanted to bring this to your notice. As a leader of a nonprofit or ministry, it's important for us to understand consumer behavior and release the content at the right time. Many times we don't think about it, but social media being a crowded space, it is important as to when you actually release your content. That could make a big difference. And considering that the first few minutes of your content and how it gets engagement and so on in the first few minutes influences the algorithm in a very big way, timing is of much importance. So do check out this report for various channels and see if you may have to do some alterations to the way you approach content for your ministry. Our next news is about working remotely or working from home during this coronavirus outbreak. I wanted to bring to your notice two resources that talk about remote work or how to work out of home effectively. Now, working out of home has become a part of many people's life around the world because of this outbreak. And two companies have really gone out to release resources that could help. One is LinkedIn. So LinkedIn has made some of their courses on the learning platform available for free, courses that talk about how to work from home. So these are very good resources, so I highly recommend you check it out. I will link to it in the show notes. Google has also given some very interesting tips on how to work out of home effectively. So do check these resources out. Our final news of this week is about the contribution of various social media channels or the steps that they have taken to help during this coronavirus outbreak. Companies like Google have come out with an article by the CEO that talks about the various steps that the company has taken, and Facebook has an entire page that keeps getting updated with their contribution, including financial grants, which runs to millions of dollars. And companies like TikTok have partnered with WHO to create resources related to coronavirus. So we have a collection of all these various articles from last week that talks about the contribution of social media channels to this outbreak. Do have a look and see if there is something that could help you as a nonprofit or a ministry if you are working in this area, and if there's a way for you to partner with these major organizations. Well, that's all I have for you this week. Thank you for joining me. We've got all the source links and details related to the stories that we talked about on our news page, natchilazarus.com/news. Thank you, and stay safe wherever you are, and keep yourself informed with the right news from right sources and experts. Do not trust all the news that you see out there on the internet. Be smart about the kind of sources that you trust when it comes to gathering information, especially medical information and news from around the world. Stay safe. May God give you the wisdom. May He protect you, your family, your work, and your ministry, and all that you do in a time as this. I speak a blessing and a protection and covering upon you and everything that you do. God bless you. I will see you next week with another set of news items. Until then, stay connected, stay blessed, and stay safe. God bless you. Bye-bye.